Good afternoon, dear colleagues. So while they're preparing the presentation, I would like to welcome you in such late hours, especially when we started at 8 o'clock, so it's late already. And I'm happy that we are here and we are presenting the materials to all of you. I'd like to thank the organizers for the opportunity to make presentation and to present state of the art technologies and discuss some difficult items and using the opinion of our experts. I would like to give further impetus for the further developments. I will be quite brief and hope there will be time for discussion. There are different aspects which we discuss here, but I'll focus on gynecological pathology. A lot of attention was given to oncogynecology from the surgical viewpoint. Cervical cancer is one of the leading pathologies in Russia. And besides, except for and despite all our efforts of the recent 15 years, the issue is still burning. And the reason is that there is a significant growth of incidence rate among young women. And many factors are burning for reproductive health and social rehabilitation. It's not just medical, but a social issue. In 2018, classification was added by some amendments, and I would like to show you this particular slide. What sort of patients and tumors are we talking about? What sort of structures of female pelvis are involved in the tumor process? What sort of tasks have to be solved by radiotherapists? Despite the gold standard for treatment of cervical cancer envisaging radical combined radiotherapy with cisplatin as well, and the results of such treatment in patients with locally advanced cervical cancer with cellular regions of the pelvis involvement, the overall 5-year overall survival doesn't exceed 30%, the high degree of relapses. More thorough analysis shows that it is heterogeneous, and fixation of secondary and 3B cervical cancer doesn't give us an idea about how the patient will respond to our treatment. It's necessary to differentiate and evaluate a tumor of cellular zones around uterus and the mechanism of the formation based on data of medical imaging, magnetic resonance imaging, multispiral CT or PET CT if they were made, and thorough analysis of the data allow to differentiate the variant of lesions in parametral cellular region, which determines differences in the rate of response. We identified three main mechanisms of the creation of parametral infiltrates at cervical cancer, in particular direct advancement of tumor to the ciliary area from the site of the cervix. Then the second is growth in parametria from metastatic changes in lymph nodes. Next is cancer embolization of lymphoblasts vascular spaces based on type of lymphangiitis. So basing on analysis of our retrospective data that helped to create control group in our trial, we concluded that response to standard chemoradiotherapy with cervical cancer are different. And patients with the second type and with the first in unfavorable prognosis when more than half of perimeter has lesions. So at standard approach, they have no future of complete cure. And thus, we have to seek for safe solutions for these issues. We used the expertise of previous generations and looked at hypothermia as a universal modificator of tumor response, which proved its efficacy in treating malignant lesions, different histological forms of localization. Here, a chairman can talk a lot with all the details, and they can share the experience of using hypothermia in treating tumor of rectum. And nevertheless, multiple discussion of this issue didn't give us any consensus. Here is a certain types of medical hypothermia. Nevertheless, those works that are available in relation to hypothermia in locally advanced tumors in the pelvis do not allow to have a straightforward answer with regards to this method, and the criticism of these works is comparable with evidence nature of these works. One of the areas of technological is oncothermia, which is considered a prospective method of radio modification. Although there is some clinch with the specialists in classical thermal hypothermia, basing on thermal dogma. What kind of method is it? It envisages local impact of high-frequency electric field modulated oscillations in certain range, and the range of frequencies is shown here. Oncothermia combines the advantages of classical soft hypothermia with the heating of the mass of tumor up to 40 degrees Celsius without risk for thermal damage of surrounding tissues, and it has a destructive effect on the membranes of tumor cells, absorbed intercellular fluid, the ability of tumor tissue and opportunity of dynamic adjustment of parameters, voltage depending on the feelings of the patient, allowed to avoid some thermal damages that are typical of classical hypothermia. Mechanism that the creators described by the creators of the method focused that thermal effect is no more than one quarter and 10% in case they use isothermal modes. The first results of the trial were presented 2 years ago, and they were criticized by the proponents of who developed classical hypothermia. Their standpoint was quite clear to us, because they allowed us to once again come back to many experimental points. And for cervical cancer, As to basic works concerning the use of modulated electrothermia, we didn't find anything. There are about five works. All of them use different design of trial and stated only clinical effects without focus on the mechanisms of and so they were criticized. So our design envisaged 54 patients with cervical cancer, parametrial cellular area was also involved, and eight patients had local regional relapses. Here you see brief characteristics. Quite unfavorable groups of patients. We couldn't rely on the effect of standard treatment. Radiation was made on the background of chemo radio modification. We used local deep modulated electrothermia. The sessions of exposition 60-90 minutes, 90-120 watt. Individual adjustment of parameters, tolerability 3 fractions per week. On average, the number of sessions the radical course was not less than 10, from 10 to 15 sessions for relapsing tumors, depending on tolerance, less, but not less than 5. We performed 427 sessions of oncothermia. In some patients, we had to discontinue the course because of local changes, fatigue, and refusal from treatment. Later, patients received brachytherapy in certain variant. The total design of the trial is shown here on the slide. Still, we went, so we preferred argument discussion with dogmas of classical hypothermia. We checked vascular effects and hypothermal effects. Those who received treatment within our trial referred to isothermal. The majority of patients had isothermal oncothermia, not exceeding 38-40 degrees, the temperature of heat, and it directly correlated with anterior-posterior size and the dose in the rectum, in the urinal bladder, vagina, and primary tumor and cervical canal had no significant differences. In general, even one measuring in one of the cavities allowed to make certain conclusions if we have to assess thermal effect. So we relied on non-thermal effects and or absence of clinical effect. Nevertheless, we received clinical effect, which was quite high, prominent complete regression in 50% partial, more than 70%. So the prospect of primary recovery more than 30%, 13% gave stabilization. Progression that is often mentioned in the discussion. So they say that prolonged heating or absence of thermal damage results in generalization of the process. So in our, we didn't see this effect in our material. As to relapses, there was quite positive dynamics, and complications were not severe. It made us consider non-thermal effect in a more detailed way. We studied the line of genes out of 24 genes, and 4 points sampling of the material was made to avoid heterogeneity of response of tumor. So we did that before treatment. in the middle of the course of radiotherapy and after the completion of radiotherapy course. As in the main as well as in reference group, we managed to take 240 samples, and the results were compared with the method of match selection. Out of panel of 24 genes, only 4 genes that are shown here demonstrate significant differences in the course of treatment in the basic and reference group. These indicators are perspective in terms of the influence of hypothermia on tumor apoptosis.
There is a tendency in of correlation of differences in the dynamics of the genes and influence on the apoptosis and on the overall treatment outcome. Combined technology of chemoelectrothermotherapy with the component radical radiation with platinum-containing regimens of chemotherapy, perspective methods of the radical treatment of cervical cancer patients with unfavorable results in case of advancement of tumor in cellular tissues in the pelvis. I'm not a great expert in oncogynecology, but I think it seems that introducing interstitially needles, we can increase substantially the exposure of the parametrium dose. And use of hypothermia and these methods may be beneficial. We dealt with hypothermia quite long ago, and we have outdated stereotypes. I noticed that the dose in the rectum of the bladder and in the tumor, the dose is identical. Formally, so the effect of hypothermia should be the similar in normal tissues as well. Are there differences in the effects in terms of hyperthermal irradiation of the rectum, and can we replace this hyperthermal component with the interstitial brachiotherapy? Answering the first question, I'd like to say that we use interstitial brachiotherapy. The modification, it happened in the phase or preliminary to brachiotherapy. I think in some sense it's a therapy of despair, because we risk extensive risk of damage of vessels and ureter to treat the tumor when we failed in treatment during the first phase. It's important to take into account the standardized geometry, a Fletcher applicator can't be adjusted. The more standardized the geometry of the tumor up to the time of brachiotherapy, it's better for the treatment, for us, and for the patient. In this situation, I think my presentation is devoted to the next phase of treatment. We apply any possible efforts to achieve the effect. In the second type of tumors, when the infiltrates are very lesions, are very huge, they can't be resolved even if they're exposed to 60 gray of irradiation. And still, we should bear in mind there is a pool of radio-resistant cells. It's first point. As to the second question, once again, I'd like to emphasize, I'd like to stress that we are used our approach of trial and mistakes. For thermal therapy, hypothermal effect per se amounts to only 10%. The damage. The damage can be overlooked in this situation because the percentage of either isothermal and mild hyperthermal situations in our group was 85%. The temperature was not higher than 40-41 degrees in the majority of our patients. It was proved that the dose in the bladder, in the rectum, in the tissues neighboring the tumor will be similar. And I think that we are unlikely to create the gradient of doses. And our hope is in the fact that different tissues, they react differently for this, for the exposure of the hyperthermal therapy. If there are no questions, I'll torture you a bit. More than 50 patients were managed with this oncothermal treatment, radiation and chemotherapy. 2D or 3D? We had only conformant 3D CRT rapid. They received the similar method of treatment, am I right? Did you have a control group with which you compare the results, your own results? Maybe historical control? Please, let's look at the design of the treatment. We had a control group, and we compared with this control group the apoptotic results. We compared three methods of treatment. And did you study the local control? And the general design of the trial. This is the main group, and the control group. In the control group, 64.3% was overall survival, progression-free survival low. It's a local treatment. For the control group, 64.3% local control of the control groups. And groups were comparable as to the stages, advancement, parametrial infiltrates. It happens that the results For the main group, we have only 3-year results, progression-free survival 91.6%. But this data are a bit raw, without deep analysis and comparison. There are many, I have many questions myself. Oncothermal therapy, it's quite rare. It's a selected overheating of tumor with a temperature of 40-41 degrees of Celsius. In the 1960s, 1970s, much experimental work was done. More than 100 departments throughout the former Soviet Union, they had there were rooms for hyperthermal therapy, but unfortunately the country collapsed and the method disappeared as well. The local hyperthermal exposure in heating, overheating tissues for 30 minutes or 1 hour, 30% of tumors disappeared, but in 6 months, relapse happened, and it's the results on animal models from 16 to 45%. In this range, we can achieve results, successful results of hyperthermia exposure. In Europe, multi-center trials showed significant improvement in the local control survival, 3, 10, 12 years survival rate. There are a great number of experimental studies. The international trials or studies that showed significant improvement in the results in certain type of localizations. A scientist from Hungary, he educated in here in St. Petersburg, and then he invented the device. Undoubtedly, at least what the authors showed, first of all, it's the pancreatic cancer, multi-center trials, randomized trials, as glioblastomas. This method is approved as a radio modification in case of glioblastomas in the USA for retroperitoneal tumors, for gynecology, for the tumors of the minor pelvis, in terms of oncothermia, I didn't find. And those that I found, they were single center, but very interesting from Poland, Hungary, from the south, from South Africa. And each trial may be critically assessed, but we couldn't make use of these designs, of their designs, because the designs of these trials were completely different. And they initially use some unfavorable modes to show the disadvantages of the methods. And hyperthermal unit, And this notion is modulated hyperthermia. It may be a part of the broader notion, the thermal medicine. Probably it's not the true hyperthermia, and it has a different mechanisms of action. The main mechanisms, core mechanisms, it's the mechanism of membrane destruction. And when we read the specifications of the devices for hyperthermia, they didn't submit their reliable scientific data, so that we re-verify the conclusions.